Hello, youngster. How are you? Welcome back to our class number 16. So let's go to the virtual classroom. And here we can see that we have to work on pages 44 and 45 from Discover English 2. Okay, let's go. Well, here we are. So we have a story to read today, Adventure Island. Okay, so tell me, do you remember the names of the characters? Can you write them on the chat? Well, I can help you. She's a J and he is Danny. All right, very good. Now tell me, what's AJ thinking? Can you see here? What's AJ thinking? Write your answer on the chat, come on. Because they are looking for the treasure, do you remember? Very good. And now tell me, how does she feel? She is hot. She is tired. Write your answer on the chat, come on. Very good. Now tell me, what is Danny doing? Pay attention to picture number one. What is Danny doing? Well, he is making a raft. This is a raft. I don't know if you remember, raft is balsa, all right? Because remember, they are looking for a treasure, all right? Very good. Well, now we are going to listen to an audio and at the same time, we are going to follow the story. Are you ready? Okay, let's go.
Unit 4C, Exercise 1. Adventure Island. Listen and read. True or false?
Hey, AJ, stop helping me.
It's too hot.
We need a raft to find the treasure.
Oh, okay then.
Is there a bigger piece? This is too small.
How about this?
It's ready.
It isn't big enough, Danny.
Don't worry, AJ. Here, take the map.
What's that? Is it a treehouse?
It's too high. I can't see.
Why don't we have a better look? Wait! Danny! The bridge isn't enough.
It's okay, AJ. Let's go. Oh!
All right, very good. So let's take a look to some phrases that appear in this story, all right? Here we have something important. AJ, what about helping me? ¿Qué tal si me ayudas? It's too hot, dice AJ. Como habíamos dicho, ella tiene mucho calor. We need a raft to find the treasure. Here we have defined raft, the word raft, all right? Is there a bigger piece? This is too small. Danny cree que el pedazo de madera que AJ le está trayendo es muy chiquitito. How about this? Pregunta AJ. It's ready. It isn't big enough, Danny, dice AJ. Está hablando del raft. Don't worry, AJ. Here, take the map. Remember that they have got a map, all right? What's that? Is it a treehouse? Vieron la casa del árbol, ¿sí? La estaban encontrando mientras estaban en el raft. It's too high. I can't see. Con esto está diciendo que está muy alta la casa del árbol. Why don't we have a better look? ¿Por qué no tenemos una vista mejor? Wait, Danny. The bridge isn't strong enough. It's okay, AJ. Let's go. Sniper, all right? This little animal we have here. Okay? Very good. So now, we are going to do together on page number 45, exercise number one, all right? Here we have to make this true or false. So now, number one is done. Danny is making a hut. Now it's false because we know that he is making a raft, all right? Now, let's do number two. Danny and AJ want to find a treasure. What do you think it's? Is it true or false? Write your answer on the chat, come on. Very good. It's true, people. Yes. Very good. Number three, the children have got the map. What do you think? Write your answer on the chat, come on. Yes, very good, it's true. The children have got the map. Number four, they go to the tree house because it's on the map. What do you think about this? Did they find the tree house on the map? True or false? Very good. It's false, all right? The tree house, it's not on the map. And number four, the bridge is very strong. What about the bridge? Is the bridge strong? Very good. It's false, all right? Because the bridge is weak, all right? Very good, children. Now, we are going to pay attention to this grammar box, all right? Let's take a look, because it's very important. Here, we have to and enough. Son dos adjetivos que vamos a utilizar, all right? But pay attention. I'm going to read the sentences for you. It's too hot. It's too hot. Are you too tired? ¿Qué pasa con este adjetivo? Este adjetivo lo ponemos adelante, all right? Siempre va a ir adelante. En este caso lo tenemos adelante de hot, yes? Y too lo tenemos adelante de tired. Okay, what about the following adjective? Here we have big, for example, big. Pero aparece enough. Bueno, como pueden ver, enough va a ir luego de big, ¿sí? Siempre que veamos enough, va a ir después, en este caso del adjetivo big. Luego tenemos otro ejemplo. Is it strong enough? De vuelta, en este caso es una pregunta y sin embargo vemos que enough sigue estando después del adjetivo strong, ¿ok? Entonces recuerden, too va a ir antes y después enough, cuando lo veamos, lo vamos a poner luego, después de los adjetivos, ¿alright? Ahora, vamos a la historia y vamos a buscar ejemplos de too y de enough. So, here. Let's pay attention to picture number one. Could you see any example? Can you see too or enough? Very good. AJ says, it's too hot. Very good. What about picture number two? Yes, very good. Here again, this is too small. They are talking about the piece. Este pedacito que ella le da a Danny, all right? Es muy chiquitito, le dice él. Number three. Could you see any example? Yes, very good. It isn't big enough. ¿Ven? Acá tenemos el ejemplo de enough y va luego de la palabra big. All right? What about picture number four? Please, write the sentence on the chat. Yes, very good. It's too high. De vuelta tenemos la palabra too. La ponemos antes del adjetivo. Very good. Number five. Wait, Danny. The bridge isn't strong enough. Acá tenemos enough nuevamente. ¿Sí? Luego del adjetivo. All right? Very good. Si pueden, márquenlo en sus libros. ¿Sí? Con alguna reglita o con algún círculo, marquen las oraciones que son muy importantes. All right, now we are going to do together exercise number two. Yes, here we have with the cartoon pictures. So first of all, we are going to order the sentences. Si prestamos atención, están desordenadas. Vamos a ordenar las siguientes oraciones. Number one is already done. AJ is too tired. And this sentence belongs to picture number one. Okay, what about number two? Tell me, which is the first word we can write here? Very good. The raft. The raft. Come on, help me through the chat. We have to use the word two. So the raft. We need a verb there. Very good. So the raft is too small. Very good, very good. Number three, the piece of wood. This is the first word, all right. So I'm going to write it here, three. The piece of wood. How can I continue here? Kids, come on, help me through the chat. We have to use enough. Pay attention. ¿Dónde vamos a poner enough? Fíjense, it isn't big enough. All right? Fíjense la grammar box. Entonces decimos, the piece of wood. Very good. The piece of wood isn't big enough. Very good. Excellent. Number four. Here we have a question. ¿Qué les dije de las preguntas? Si a la palabra enough la poníamos después del adjetivo, por más que sea una pregunta, lo seguimos poniendo después del adjetivo. Entonces, which is the first word? Remember that this is a question, all right? Very good. So my first word would be is. And then, is sniper. Very good. How can I continue? Help me through the chat. Very good, children. Is sniper. Si tenemos que utilizar enough, vamos a poner is sniper strong enough. Very good. Lo voy a poner así, así lo pueden leer. Very good. Excellent. Now, let's do number five. We have the tree house. All right, the tree house. What about the tree house? Yes, this is our first word. The tree house. How can I continue? Come on, help me. Here we have to use two. So the tree house, very good, is too high. Excellent. And now number six. We have to use two. So come on, write the entire phrase, the entire sentence on the chat. Excellent, children. The bridge is too dangerous. Very, very good. Now that we already finished these sentences and we have these sentences in order, we are going to match them with the cartoon pictures. We know that number one, yes, belongs to picture number one. But what about number two? The raft is too small. Can you tell me? It belongs to picture number, what do you think? Tell me, are you is too? Let's read it again. The raft is too small. Yes, very good. It belongs to picture number three. All right, so we are going to write here picture number three. All right, very good. What about sentence? No, sorry. The piece of wood here we are. The piece of wood isn't big enough. Here I am. The piece of wood isn't big enough. Tell me, it belongs to picture number? They are talking about a piece of wood. Yes, very good. It belongs to picture number two. So here in sentence number three, we are going to say that it belongs to picture number two. All right, very good. Now, let's read sentence number four. Sentence number four says, is sniper strong enough? Is sniper strong enough? Tell me, who is sniper? Yes, very good. Here it is. This is sniper. All right, very good. So it belongs to picture number six. All right, let's write number six over here. Very good. Sentence number five. The tree house is too high. The tree house is too high. Tell me which is the picture where we can see that the treehouse is too high. Very good. It's picture number four. All right. So we are going to write here number four. And the last one. The bridge is too dangerous. So tell me which is the picture where we can see that the bridge. Excellent, people. It's picture number five. Can't you see the bridge here? Yes, it's true. It's too dangerous. So here we are going to write that belongs to picture number 5. All right? Very, very good. Excellent, excellent job, kids. Congratulations. Well, now you are going to continue working with your teacher through Zoom. All right, kids. See you. Bye-bye.